TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surabhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 26th of September. Prime Minister Modi invites global business community to invest in India. UN approves Pakistan's request to allow Hafiz Saeed to use his bank account. And Afghans hope for peace and fair votes ahead of presidential poll. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday urged the global investors and businesses to invest in India to avail the global opportunity arising out of its huge market. In his keynote address at the Bloomberg Global Business Forum in New York, Modi said, his government is working towards improving the business environment in the country.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi made a major push for foreign investment in India and urged the global investors and businesses to avail the golden opportunity arising out of its huge market, its huge infrastructure ecosystem, and a growing startup ecosystem. Addressing the Bloomberg Global Business Forum on Wednesday in New York, Prime Minister Modi said India is an ideal destination for investors and offers a golden opportunity to partner with, as he also listed a list of reasons why the investors should come to India. His speech conveyed the message to global investors that they can come to India irrespective of their area of interest.
If you want to invest in one of the world's largest infrastructure ecosystems, come to India. We are rapidly modernizing our cities and equipping them with latest technology and citizen-friendly infrastructure. Thus, if you want to invest in urbanization, come to India.
Prime Minister Modi later met more than 40 top American business leaders and interacted with them on the sidelines of United Nations General Assembly in a bid to boost commercial ties between New Delhi and Washington. The extensive agenda included harnessing investment opportunities in India and boosting commercial linkages between the two nations. Later in the day, Prime Minister Modi met his Armenian and New Zealand counterparts and the President of Estonia. During his meeting with New Zealand Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern, they held talks underlining the strong commonalities and shared values between the two countries have provided a solid bedrock for relations to flourish.
Indian Foreign Minister Subramaniam Jaishankar has slammed Pakistan and said that India cannot talk to a very challenging neighbour that conducts terrorism as a legitimate tool of statecraft to put pressure on New Delhi to come to the negotiating table.
Indian Foreign Minister Subramaniam Jaishankar has hit out at Pakistan for exporting terrorism in India. Addressing an event at leading think tank Council on Foreign Relations in New York on Wednesday, Jaishankar was asked about Jammu and Kashmir and how he looks to manage New Delhi's relationship with Islamabad. Jaishankar said that India cannot talk to a very challenging neighbor that conducts terrorism as a legitimate tool of statecraft to put pressure on New Delhi to come to the negotiating table and follows a policy of implausible deniability.
Norm of international relations anymore. There's no part in the world, I mean, you have terrorism in different parts of the world, but there's no part of the world where a country uses it consciously, deliberately, as a large-scale industry against its neighbor.
Creating an analogy between cricket and terrorist attacks which happened in India on intervals, Jaishankar said, India is a democracy and people will not accept cricket and terror. We cannot take a tea break next day and then play cricket. Tensions between the two countries have spiked after India ended the special status of Jammu and Kashmir on August 5th. The abrogation of Article 370 evoked strong reactions from Islamabad, which downgraded ties and expelled the Indian ambassador.
The United Nations Security Council has allowed globally designated terrorist Hafiz Saeed access to his frozen bank account after Pakistan made a plea on his behalf. The development comes despite Pakistan's claims of stringent action against terrorism on its soil.
The United Nations Security Council or UNSC has allowed 2008 Mumbai attacks mastermind Hafiz Saeed access to his bank account, which had been frozen because of the world body's sanction after Pakistan made a plea on his behalf. The UN Sanctions Committee said it had received a letter from Pakistan seeking permission to allow Saeed certain expenditure from his frozen bank account on August 15. The chair said no objection had been received from any member and hence Pakistan's request was approved. Incidentally, Pakistan's request backing Hafiz Saeed's claim that he needed money for basic expenses for himself and his family was filed just a month after the Lashkar-e-Taiba terror group founder was taken into custody for financing terror. The development comes despite Pakistan's claim that it is taking stringent actions against terrorism.
Moving on, a political activist from Pakistan-administered Kashmir, Dr. Amzad Ayub Mirza, has said that Pakistan is an occupier and has no regard for people's rights, as it claims in the case of Kashmiris. He made the remarks over Pakistan's efforts to internationalize the Kashmir issue, which have constantly failed. Dr. Amzad Ayub Mirza, a political activist from Pakistan-administered Kashmir, has said that Pakistan is an occupier and has no regard for people's rights, as it has been claiming globally over the Kashmir issue. Mirza said Pakistani Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi's raising of the Kashmir issue at the UNHRC earlier this month was superficial, as Islamabad itself has been committing atrocities in the illegally occupied region of Pakistan-administered Kashmir since over 70 years. He said Pakistan failed to get the support of the other UN members to move a resolution against India's move of abrogation of special status of Jammu and Kashmir, as the international community is aware of Pakistan's hypocrisy.
Kashmir banega Pakistan. Ye nara lagate hi usne apne hi cause ko defeat kar diya. Yani aap UN resolution jo hai uske mutabik aap ek taraf kehte hain Kashmiriyon ko khud mukhtari honi chahiye, azadi honi chahiye, aur aap khud ye keh rahe hain ki haan khud mukhtari to denge lekin zameen hamari hogi. ये कौन सी खुदमुख्तारी है तो ये सब जो है ये एक प्रॉपर्ली प्लान्ड है
मिर्ज़ा सेड व्हेन इन पाकिस्तान एडमिनिस्ट्रेट कश्मीर पाकिस्तानी प्राइम मिनिस्टर इमरान खान एंड हिज कैबिनेट स्पीक वॉल्यूम अबाउट स्टैंडिंग फॉर द राइट्स ऑफ कश्मीरीज बट देयर टोन एंड टेनर चेंजेस व्हेन दे स्पीक इन देयर ओन पार्लियामेंट ही हाईलाइटेड दैट पीपल इन पाकिस्तान एडमिनिस्ट्रेट कश्मीर आर सिस्टमैटिकली टारगेटेड Rights for them exist on paper, but they cannot even turn their heads without permission. Their dissent and dissatisfaction is muzzled with highest degree of force. Afghan voters who are all set to go to the polls on Saturday have said that they will be looking for peace, stability and a righteous person to lead the war-torn country. They said they hope that it will be a transparent election and the new president can get their country out of the current crisis.
At a time when Afghanistan's twice-delayed presidential election is just around the corner, registered voters have expressed their will for peace and stability in the war-torn country. Thousands of soldiers, police and civilians have been killed in the last 5 years in Afghanistan, leaving Afghans wary of endless violence and widespread corruption in public life. Though election officials in the country say preparations are well in hand, the Taliban has made its aim to disrupting the election clear with recent attacks.
اصغر مهرزاده هستم رئیس مؤسسه صلح و سبک آزاد و کلاب دراپ اند رایت در مورد انتخابات پیشروی امیدوار هستم که یک انتخابات شفاف برگزار شود تا اینکه یک کس در رأس جمهور قرار بگیره و بتونه کشور از حالت فعلی یعنی از حالت بحران بیرون بکشه و بتونیم به صلح و صلح و آرامی دستیاب شویم
من محمد اشرف فرزند حاجی بیولای آهنگر 32 ساله هستم مدت 20 سال میشه کار انگاری میکنم آمدیم در مورد انتخابات نگاه میخواهیم که یک انتخابات خوب بشوری داشته باشیم و از تمام مردم خود تقاضا میکنیم که یک شخص بسیار نیک مسلمان عادل رای بتن که انتخاب شود. بخیر.
Incumbent President of Afghanistan Ashraf Ghani came to power in 2014 after winning a bitterly disputed election marked by accusations of cheating. His government has struggled to combat a growing Taliban insurgency over the years. Ghani is now bidding for a second five-year term against a crowded field of 15 candidates, including Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah.
News from Sri Lanka. At least one person was killed and over 80,000 people affected in Sri Lanka following incessant rains in the island nation over the past few days. President Maithripala Sirisena has instructed authorities to provide immediate relief to those affected by the ongoing adverse weather conditions.
At least one person was killed and over 80,000 people affected by days of heavy rains and strong winds, which lashed out across Sri Lanka, the Disaster Management Center said on Wednesday. Several areas in the southern part of the country were inundated, while over 14,000 people had been evacuated to safer locations, according to officials. The National Building Research Organization, or NBRO, on Thursday issued a landslide warning in the Kalutara district, in the western coast of the island, and in the Gull district in the south. The NBRO issued a red warning and urged rescue officials to evacuate residents living in landslide-prone areas to safer shelters. Meanwhile, Sri Lankan President Maithripala Sirisena has instructed authorities to provide immediate relief to the thousands of people affected by the ongoing adverse weather conditions. The Meteorology Department, in its latest weather update, said heavy rains and strong winds would continue across Sri Lanka till Thursday.
Nepal police on Wednesday rounded up 12 suspects for attempting to steal 5 billion Nepali rupees from various banks and financial institutions in the country through hacking.
Nepal police on Wednesday said they have rounded up 12 suspects for attempting to steal 5 billion Nepali rupees from various banks and financial institutions in the country through hacking. According to a Metropolitan Police Crime Division official, the suspects were rounded up from different parts of the country who had attempted to steal 40.7 million Nepali rupees from Agriculture Development Bank. The mastermind behind the huge financial racket has been identified as Peter Aka Kale. While the police are yet to determine the exact location of Kale, they said he used a texting application, WeChat, for correspondence with the fixers.
रुंदै जादा के सम्म हामीले पायौ भने 50 मिलियन डलर्स भन्नाले 5 अरब नेपाली रुपैयाँ चाहिँ हायक हुन सक्ने सम्भावना यति सम्मको ट्रान्ज्याक्सन हुन सक्ने भन्ने कुराहरु यो अहिले जसले हायक गर्यो त्यसको एजेन्ट हामीले जुन पक्राउ गरेको छौ त्यो एजेन्टको माध्यमबाट त्यो पुर्न आएको छ.
The incident comes in less than a month when the police had arrested 6 Chinese nationals in connection with an ATM fraud in which 12.54 million Nepali rupees were withdrawn from various ATM booths across the country.
A 37-year-old housewife from India's Western Vadodara city has been crowned Mrs. India. Pooja Desai, who emerged victorious after competing with over 4,500 participants, said she believes women should never listen to others and do what they actually want to do with their lives. Beating all odds of age, a 37-year-old homemaker from India's Western Vadodara city has been crowned Mrs. India. The newly crowned Mrs. India, Pooja Desai, won the title after competing with over 4,500 participants from across the country. Desai thinks women should have a right to choose their lives and what they want to do with their lives. She believes women cannot be the ones who always listen to others.
Women should have a right to choose their lives and what they want to do with their lives. They cannot be the ones who always listen to the shots called by others.
Mrs. India is a sought-after title among the married women, and it gives a platform to them to pursue a career in the fashion and entertainment industry. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.